Hello, this is Dr. Patrick Nemechek of Nemechek Autonomic Medicine. I want to give a quick review of our study on vagus nerve stimulation in acute COVID-19 infection. This is an interim safety analysis of the first 25 patients that have been treated. As you may be aware, in my other publications and just the copious amount of information on the internet, coronavirus pandemic is resulting in a high degree of mortality. We've seen here 61% early in China, Italy was around 26%, in adults over 65 in the U.S., mortality is running about 30 to 40%. When you look at what's happening to the patients, there's a wide range of problems, from diffuse blood clotting through the lungs in particular, septic shock, lung injury from both the clotting as well as inflammatory damage to the heart. The immune system is seeming to be overwhelmed with production of some autoantibodies, and renal failure. What's central to all of this is what is referred to as the cytokine storm. Cytokines are inflammatory molecules that are released from your immune system when active. We need a little bit of this to help you sprain an ankle or fight an infection, but they should turn on and shut off. What's happening in the cytokine storm is things are spinning out of control, and these cytokines are potentially the mechanism that's actually damaging all the organs. And then you get immune system failure, secondary infections, and then can ultimately cause death. We also see that many of the risk factors associated with COVID-19, chronic lung disease, heart disease, obesity, diabetes, chronic kidney disease, and these immunocompromised states are all elevated pro-inflammatory states, in that what it potentially could be is that these patients do, with those conditions, do worse because their existing inflammation is basically magnifying the already difficult cytokine storm from COVID-19. In particular, there is a thing called ARDS, or acute respiratory distress syndrome, or ARDS. This is a diffuse inflammatory process. As you can see, these dark areas here in the rib cage, that's kind of lung. It should be much clearer, this fine, what we call reticular pattern, ground glass pattern, is diffuse. Now here you can see that's in the red bar. These are findings of ARDS in patients with COVID-19 pneumonia. And there's some studies showing that the higher the cytokine levels, the more greater severity you have. And here you can see both interleukin-2, interleukin-6, and tumor necrosis factor, all very classic pro-inflammatory cytokine levels are all elevated when severe versus moderate. Here severe, moderate, and here severe, moderate. Standard treatment at the beginning has been basically just supporting the patients and trying to ride them through it while their body fights the infection, because we had no medications. What we are theorizing is that vagus nerve stimulation can have an impact on the excessive inflammatory state that's common. Here, vagus nerve stimulation in our process is done at the ear. It's called transcutaneous auricular vagus nerve stimulation. What that does is it helps to stabilize, well, the vagus nerve controls your immune system essentially and controls all inflammation. And it, by stimulating the nerve, it improves the working point of the inflammatory system so that it's able to better regulate inflammation. So here with the high COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2 inflammatory state, vagus nerve stimulation can block and regulate the spleen, the inflammatory reaction in the lungs, and the inflammatory reaction in the gut can all be downregulated by VNS. So there are attempts here to use drugs like remdesivir and possibly the immune globulins that they're using. Our suggestion is to use vagus stimulation in concert with these other things to decrease cytokine release and then hopefully improve survival. Kind of a busy slide, I apologize, but basically we've got a lot of drugs we can use. There aren't many good options. They're expensive, they can cause infections, and they're often limited availability. The vagus nerve stimulator we know is effective in human and animal data. It regulates the cytokines that can contribute to this. It's very, very safe. And through the transcutaneous stimulation at the ear, it is very, very simple and inexpensive to use. So what we decided is to do a study looking at vagus nerve stimulation and see if that would improve outcomes. The study was done in Buenos Aires at a public hospital there. Our goal is to have 50 subjects. At the time of this recording, the study has been closed. We've fully enrolled all of our studies. This paper, this presentation is only on the first half. All patients got whatever routine care the doctors wanted to provide, plus 5 minutes of vagus nerve stimulation, repeated 4 times a day until they were discharged. And we were just looking at survival and whether they needed a mechanical ventilation. This has been published in the Journal of Clinical and Experimental Immunology last month. Here's just a picture of the hospital in Argentina. Here is the device. We use the Vitality Smartcable, which can go either on the tragus or laterally in the concha. And basically it is a some microprocessors are in this cable and they help regulate electricity. And it's the electricity is provided by the phone and regulated by a app in the phone. In terms of adverse events, out of our first 25, we only had 2. One had some numbness of the mouth, and the other was had some orthostatic hypotension, which is basically just low blood pressure when you're in the upright position. Both of these individuals, their symptoms resolved spontaneously and did not recur when they just used a little bit lower voltage on the device, and both patients survived. What we found that was quite surprising is the dramatic reduction in need for mechanical ventilation. We only had 2 out of 25 patients needed to be on mechanical ventilation. That's a dramatic reduction from what you see in other studies. I'll show some comparisons for you in a minute. We also had a very, very impressive rate of survival. Only 16% of the patients died. Some cohorts run up to about 50% of patients might actually die. In both of these groups, both on mechanical, those who did not have mechanical ventilation, there's actually a large number of people with comorbid conditions that we talked about before. And the same thing here, many of the survivors were actually had a high degree of comorbidity. When you compare this to other studies, now although our numbers are low at present, we will have another publication showing all 50, but you can see here our overall mortality is only at 16%. Basically, there's only 2 other cohorts like that in both in New York there, but it is lower than all other reported cohorts at this point in time. And our mechanical ventilation rate is dramatically lower and on par with what you might see in the United Kingdom. So VNS, at least in the interim, is associated with a low mortality and a low need for mechanical ventilation in patients with acute COVID-19 infection. So now we have VNS, 5 minutes, 4 times a day. This was started when they came in the hospital. we are seeing less ARDS, respiratory failure, and improved survival. Thank you very much.